As young witches and wizards, we all dream about soaring through the sky like our favorite heroes. When it comes to Quidditch, we've all wondered, do I have what it takes to be the next Quidditch star? To beat my toughest opponents? To keep my composure when it matters most? To chase my dreams at any price? To seek glory for my team? Because someday, that dream could become a reality. And the road won't always be easy. But if you just keep getting back on your broom and trust in your teammates, Quidditch is magic. So ask yourself again, do you have what it takes? Do you have the heart of a Quidditch champion? Every Quidditch champion's journey has to start somewhere. And for many, that's in our own backyard. In our minds, the garden is a grand Quidditch pitch, and wind blowing in the trees is a roaring crowd. Can you picture yourself playing among your heroes? Each team has three chasers. They're the heart of the Quidditch team, if I do say so myself. That ball is called the quaffle, and the chaser's job is to, well, chase it. When the other team has the quaffle, our chasers need to get it back at all costs and bring it towards the opponent's goal. And working as one, throwing the quaffle through any opposing goal scores our team points and brings us that much closer to victory.
Quidditch would be rubbish without the keeper guarding the goals. A good defense can make all the difference in a match. Your team's keeper has one very important job. Stop that quaffle from going through any of your goals. Being a good keeper requires the tactical mind to predict where the quaffle will be shot and the agility to stop it. With their vantage point, a keen keeper inspire and guide their chasers as well. It may sound like a lot of responsibility, but nothing beats the feeling of single-handedly saving a goal.
Ah, beaters. You either love them or hate them, depending on which side of the bludger you're on.
What are bludgers?
They're iron balls that are fast, aggressive, and enchanted to knock players off their brooms. A beater's job is to use a bat to drive those nasty buggers away from your team, or theirs. What could be better than seeing your opponent set up a perfect play and totally ruining their plans?
Everybody knows the Seeker. Their job is to find and catch the elusive golden snitch to score big for their team. Easier said than done, as it's the size of a walnut. I suppose they don't call it seeking for nothing. But aside from sharp eyes, better have sharp reflexes too. Because once you find the snitch, you'll also need to chase it and grab it before the opposing seeker does. If you can stay close to the snitch, anticipate its movements, and dodge a bludger or two, you can actually hold victory in your hands.
At Hogwarts, there are few greater ways to bring honor to your house than playing on the Quidditch team. Against the likes of Gryffindor, Hufflepuff, Ravenclaw, and Slytherin, could you win the Hogwarts House Quidditch Cup?
And with that victory, Canada have won the coveted Quidditch World Cup.